Senator Pat Ritchie, Chair of the Agriculture Commissioner Committee, excuse me.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Just to follow up on the Assemblyman's question, the apple growers lost 70% of their crop, and with that, part of their assessment for advertising. So my question would be, because we want to make sure that New York State farmers do not lose any of their market share, is there a way to address that between the legislature and possibly the Department of Ag and Markets to make sure that that doesn't happen?
Well, certainly we can, I think we can enhance our promotional efforts. As you know, there is a market order. Well, we could work with the market order to see if maybe there's some enhancement of the checkoff program for the market order, Senator. And as I said earlier, there's no question that it was more regionalized than a lot of people realize. Certainly we recognize that the North Country was hurt particularly hard, but we had some others down the Hudson and even in central New York that didn't have the kind of devastation that you folks did up in the North Country. So we certainly can look at that.
Great. Could you just explain, you know, it's wonderful to see how focused the governor is on agriculture in the state, recognizing that it's the number one industry. And when the governor's budget came out, there's a number of programs that are included in there that, you know, are critical programs, but there are a few that are not included, and some like farm viability that's been knocked down from 1.2 to 400,000. And that program is one of the programs that I hear from, you know, farmers across the state saying that they provide critical research and is so important to what they do. So could you kind of just shed some light on how you pick which programs are funded and which ones may not be?
We recognize the importance of the Farm Viability Institute. And in fact, we have been talking with the various stakeholders to see how we could enhance that program. I believe the funding that you see would be in addition to, I believe we have a $1.2 million reappropriation there. So the governor has shown his commitment by adding the additional $400,000. This has to be farmer driven. You know, the Farm Viability Institute Board of Directors is diverse. There's a very good mix of some very fine farmers who weigh those, the various commodities to see where the research is most appropriate. And we believe it's important to have that institute be farmer driven and with those decisions. That's not to say that they won't listen to us and we won't weigh in, Senator, but we think it's important for that process to be farmer-driven.
So that 1.2 you're talking about is the money that was in last year's budget that has been reappropriated and it's not been spent? Because one of the other concerns that I hear is that because the state's funding is always somewhat on a lag, it's hard for them to put programs in place not knowing whether the funding for the following year. So if they use this funding this year, the 1.2, then the budget only has $400,000 to continue that, so we're still at a $800,000 loss there, correct?
I understand exactly what you're saying, and as I say, we're really looking with the Institute as well as other partners at how we can enhance the effectiveness of the Farm Viability Institute. We see it as a very important entity, but we're not sure that it's as effective as it can be. So we're looking at various options, talking with our other partners to see if there's a way in which we can put in place some mechanisms that would allow us to expand that program, to attract more dollars to it, more federal dollars, perhaps even private dollars.
Can you just expand a little bit on what you mean by maybe not as effective as it should be or could be?
We just think that there's opportunity to grow the program. We believe there are other research projects and programs out there that could be enhanced with additional revenues, additional dollars, and we're just not certain that it's being as effective as it can be. We believe that there may be opportunities to expand the board, include more partners. We're also taking a look at, have been looking at the possibility of creating a foundation, which you may have may have heard something about. We'd like, we've given some thought to creating a foundation where we could actually attract some private dollars from corporations or interested individuals through their social agenda to enhance what government can come up with some private dollars. So we want to attract more dollars, and we want to see if we can't find a way to move those dollars out more quickly and more effectively.
Well, I can just say from my standpoint that one of the programs that I hear from, you know, on a regular basis that has been so helpful and so critical, especially in the district that I represent, is farm viability. So, you know, I appreciate working closely with the Assemblyman in restoring that funding last year and actually increasing it $200,000 and restoring it the year before. So for me, it'll be a priority to make sure that that's included in the budget.
We certainly look forward to working with you.
And one last question. Reducing taxes on farmers' property taxes has been a priority for me. And a few years ago, there was a bill that was passed that would limit the increase to 10%. Last year, I introduced a bill that would cap that at 2% per year, because that's one of the driving costs for farmers across the state. Could you just tell me what your feelings are on that bill?
As a farmer myself, and I know the commissioner as a farmer feels the same way, the ag assessment program, we believe, needs a hard look. We need to look and see what can be done there. There's no question that that limit, that ceiling has been problematic. And so we've worked with Farm Bureau, and we'll continue to work with Farm Bureau and other entities to see if we can't do something inside that law, inside the ag district law, to make provisions so that we can do a better job to make sure that the values are being kept in line with the exemptions. And in fact, of course, as you know, it's a local function. The assessing function is a local function, so we'll need to educate those on the local level once we can make some changes inside that regulation and that law to make sure that we can do all we can to keep farmers on the land. And we certainly recognize the burden that by the very nature of our business of having large land holdings, how important it is that we enjoy the provisions underneath the ag district's law itself. So I understand completely what you're saying. I'm living it, actually.
Okay, thank you.
No? Oh, Senator Ritchie to close.
Denny.
Just a follow-up question, maybe a point of clarification to Senator Kachik's question about farm viability and the 1.2 reapprope and the 400,000. That 1.2, which is a reapprope from last year, always carries over. So in the governor's proposal, that 400,000 is actually an $800,000 cut to the program, correct?
$800,000 cut to the appropriation.
Okay, to the program itself, since it always follows over. So next year, even if the 1.2 is carrying over next year, it's going to be $800,000 short from the 1.2 if, in fact, it's not restored again by the legislature.
Yeah, I mean, I think the reality, Senator, is that the Farm Viability Institute, in spite of their best efforts, were not able to move the amount of money that they wanted to move. And so you're right, it is a shorter appropriation, but with the money that's there, the reapprope, in addition to this money, we'll see another year. You know, the department may advocate considerably more money there. As I say, we're really looking at how we can enhance the way that institute is working and how we can be more of a backstop for them. We've had several conversations with the key stakeholders, and it's sort of working its way through the process with the various farm organizations and the farmers that are most prominent on the institute. So I think we'll see some changes there. Obviously, our intent is to make it work better. And that's what we're hoping to see.
So is it safe to say you're supportive of the program, but there's not a funding level there? Or I'm kind of getting, I think, a mixed message here with your talking about maybe they could do it better. So I guess my question would be, are you supportive of the program, but there's not enough resources there? Or do you have issues with the program itself?
I certainly don't have problems with the program itself. We believe in the program. We're not certain that there may be a better way. By growing the institute, by growing the membership, we believe there are some other entities that could be represented there. We also believe that we can do some things, structurally, that will allow it to be more effective. I'm not sure if that answers your question or not, but...
I understand these are really trying times, trying to put money back in for the maple producers and some of the programs that the legislature has been able to restore over the past 2 years that I believe, and I know many who are up here, are critically important. But I don't understand how we're saying we're going to expand and bring more stakeholders in if we're cutting $800,000 out of the program. So, I'm just trying to make it make sense in my mind how, if you think the program is good and you want to grow the program and add more stakeholders, how taking $800,000 out of the program is going to do anything other than to cripple it.
Yeah, we certainly don't want to hurt the program, but it's the sense we have from a number of the key people that are, number of the key farmers that are around the table, is that they believe there's some tweaking that could be done to make it much more effective. The operating budget is flat, it's stable. So again, we see the real value in the Farm Viability Institute, and it would be our intent to enhance their effectiveness. And as I say, we're really looking at a number of different proposals that various entities have stepped forward with for us to consider. So,
well, I would appreciate during the discussions if you found it that you could keep us in the loop. That would be helpful, because I'm actually hearing somewhat of a different story for the people who are coming to the office. And so if you could keep us in the loop, that would be helpful. Thank you.
We will certainly do that, Senator.
Okay. Thank you.